What is up, everybody? Welcome to A Sum of Two Buses. Today's episode is going to be dealing with the D-Live's dual stage tube preamp emulation. There are two different emulations offered on each channel of the D-Live platform, and I just wanted to dive into this one because it kind of came out of nowhere for me. Why are tubes important? Well, that's a good question. I kind of feel like if there's any way to get more harmonic content out of your sources, I feel like it's the recipe for the best success. I feel like being able to saturate your certain instruments, depending on what instruments there are, can sometimes help a little bit when you're dealing with compression, your release, your overall RMS, and these kinds of things will give you a fuller sound. Today, we're going to be demonstrating a little bit of what our show sounds like before everything shut down. It's going to be Andrew Marshall playing the drums on Everything I Wanted by Billie Eilish, and it was from the Orlando show, which is the second of three shows we did this year. All right, so here's what we're talking about today. This little guy, right? Make sure this is up on the screen. It's got some interesting things. I found that the pentode stage was a little bit more, I don't know, pleasant to me. I feel like a little bit of high-mid aggression came from the triode version. I haven't tried this on everything, but this is what I found, and these are some of the settings that I've been using on some of the drums. And you'll notice I'm using my trim to dive pretty hard into this. Now, for this demonstration, I set up two different scenes, right? I have a drum pre-saturation and post-saturation. Now, if we go to that and we fire this, and we go back to our drums, we notice our preamp model is gone. Yes, it is gone. Not forever. So if we go back to that, there it is. But you notice the trim kind of dives up a little bit. Let's do a little quick layout of the drums of what we got going on today. All right, now I don't do a kick out mic, so I just do a kick in, and then I do a double of that, a kick parallel compressed version. Now we have a kick trigger, which is relevant for this show and this song, but I have it muted for the demonstration. I have a snare top and bottom, and then I have a parallel compressed version of the snare top and bottom. And then the snare trigger, which is not applicable for this song, and then we have a snare two or a side snare, and then a snare, side snare, parallel compressed version of that same snare. And then we have a hi-hat, rack tom, floor tom, a floor tom two, and overheads. Now we'll be focusing on all the acoustic drums today. All the processing is happening on the channels. That's all happening within the D-Live platform. I am working with two groups of drums. Let's jump over to the waves. Now, in waves, I have two, like I said, two groups. I have a drum group, which includes all those acoustic drums that I just listed. It does not include the electronic drums or kick triggers or snare triggers, which are all creative, not for matters of being replaced. So now the first group, like I said, all drums, including my hi-hat and overheads. And then the second group is the drum parallel compressed version of that, which is going to be the shells. When I say shells, I mean the kick drum, the snare drums, both snare drums, and the toms, not including the overheads or hi-hat. These are inserted on the group inside D-Live. If you look here, so right here, insert right here, okay? And we'll jump back over there. That's kind of what I've got going on. Pretty straightforward. Now, like I said, I have these two scenes set up, level matched, so that way we can hear the difference between a pretty aggressive saturation and no saturation at all, and I level matched them. So what we'll do, let's go ahead and fire off the drum pre-saturation, and then we'll play a couple bars. Thank you. All right. So you can see no emulations available on the channel. Doesn't sound too bad, if I do say so myself. All right, let's go ahead and fire post-saturation. All right, so that's a quick little overview. We didn't get quite to the floor toms, but here's the settings for that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to play it back to back, and I'm going to give you a little hands up when I basically turn on the saturation so that we can do a back to back demonstration. All right, pretty cool, right? I'd say it's pretty awesome. There's definitely a difference in the low-mid information, the extension of the kick drum. I feel like it adds a little bit more of a body to it. I feel like the overall drums feel a little bit more pokier without the stage valves on the channels. All right, let's go ahead and look at each channel and see what I'm doing on the stage valve, how hard I'm hitting the dual stage valve on each channel. This is the kick in. Kick in parallel compressed version. Here are the snare top and bottom, which is not played in this little bit. Look like a little distortion on the bottom. All right, here's the snare two. And then the snare parallel compressed version of that. All right, hold on to your hats. Here's the hi-hat. All right, see, look at that. Pretty crazy settings there, driving in pretty hard on the trim. Here's a rack tom. I'll wait for it to hit. And here's floor tom. And then the floor tom two. Now these are not really being hit or played right now. And here's the overheads. Notice I went with a high filter lift, give it a little bit of that shininess from the tubes. Pretty cool. Yeah. Like I said before, setting up these tube saturation emulations in the beginning, I didn't spend too much time on it, and I felt like it was a pretty subtle thing. But once you understand what can be achieved by diving into them pretty hard, it'll give you a better idea how to run your gain structure. Now, granted, it's a little crazy in some parts, but I'm doing some of those things purposefully. So definitely go ahead and jump into this guy. It's pretty neat. Like I said, it's got the harmonic control, the high lift, and then it has the output And then options for a second stage, which is hence why it's called a dual stage valve. And I'm not using that, but it can be a good way to crunch up a signal. Well, that's it for this episode of A Sum of Two Buses. If you guys dug it, please like, please share, and please subscribe to this channel. And I hope you guys are staying safe. Till next time.